Hi guys, today I will introduce an ancient cave system in China called Wushan Grottoes, which is a large-scale quarry with over 840 caves. This beautiful scenic site is one of 15 massive ancient quarries located in one region by the West Pacific. All of these quarries share distinct machine marks dated 1500 to 2000 years old. Could these caves be remnants of a prehistory lost civilization? If so, then why are there no big stone structures in ancient China? Where did the megatons of quarry stone end up? Were these caves even intended to quarry stone? These questions I attempt to answer. First, let's discuss important background information on the significance of this site location. So far, 15 large quarries are found in Zhejiang province, which adjoins the East China Sea. Two-thirds of the sea is composed of a largely shallow continental shelf. 11,000 years ago, the sea level was 40 meters or 131 feet lower. 19,000 years ago, during the Last Glacial Period, the sea level was 110 meters or 360 feet lower, which means almost the entire continental shelf at the East China Sea was above sea level. During this time, the current-day island of Taiwan and the Japanese archipelago were all connected on land with the Eurasia Plain. Glaciers covered the entirety of Canada, part of America, and parts of Europe, though East China stayed ice-free. The Last Glacial Period lasts over 100,000 years, which is plenty of time for civilization to thrive and progress. Here is a map of East Asia at the peak of the Ice Age, the last glacier maximum, where sea level was about 120 meters lower. Any areas with higher elevation were covered with ice. Today's submerged continental shelf back then was a green and habitable oasis. Any advanced civilizations during that time could have excavated the massive quarries to build phenomenal structures, which now could be hidden by sand and submerged at the bottom of the sea. The mysterious underwater city, Yonaguni Monument, is not too far from the quarry site at less than 300 miles away. Currently, Yonaguni is 26 meters below sea level. This means it was above sea level and connected with the East China Plain during the Last Glacial Period. It's much debated among archaeologists on whether it's a man-made structure or naturally formed. Maybe I'll do a future video on this interesting site. Wushan Grottoes is located in this region next to the East China Sea. It's a large-scale stone quarry with a myriad of excavated caves, cliffs, and pools. It's now a tourist site since the quarried stone has changed an ordinary hill into a stunning, majestic landscape. The cave writings and reliefs were added later as tourist attractions. The porous nature of the stone might be the reason why there are small holes in some caves. There are many bell caves and pools whose depths remain unverified. The tool marks at Wushan Grottoes are uniform, continuous, and horizontal, very similar to the ones seen at Changyu Caves. The numerous marks are parallel and tightly placed. It appears as if someone ran a huge comb with diamond teeth over the stone, leaving these distinct marks. I think this is an obvious sign that the marks were not created by hand tools. It's unnatural for us to hammer horizontally with chisels, which are used for smaller scale detailed masonry work. It will be extremely difficult, if not impossible, for a mason to use a chisel to carve an accurate, continuous, and smooth horizontal mark around the circumference of a big cave, not to mention creating countless parallel marks. As for pickaxes, how could a person swing one sideways to make horizontal marks on rock? It's not possible. Hand tools cannot achieve this level of accuracy or consistency, especially on such a mammoth scale.
So what kinds of tools were used at this ancient quarry? A clue is that the tool marks found on site match modern-day mining machine marks. Here are side-by-side tool mark comparison photos of different ancient sites like Baalbek, Yangshan Quarry, Petra, and other sites. The similarities are uncanny and beg the question, are these tool marks proof of an advanced prehistory global civilization? The curved surfaces and corners were most likely created from complex machinery like a modern-day rotary drum cutter or a continuous miner machine. Here are some local houses and walls made with quarried stone from parts of Wushan. They have a rustic charm due to the small stone blocks and rubble. These houses stand in sharp contrast to the smooth-shaved faces at Wushan Grottoes. It's hard to imagine that the people who quarried Wushan would build comparatively crude houses. Whoever made Wushan Grottoes were certainly capable of building impressive structures. Therefore, I believe these stone houses were not made by the creators of Wushan Grottoes, but by local Chinese. The real creators of Wushan could very well be from an advanced lost civilization. Wushan and similar sites are called quarries, but their original purpose probably are not to produce stone blocks or slabs. The tool marks at Wushan are very different from the saw marks typically used to create stone blocks or slabs. Current modern machines that can create similar tool marks as the ones at Wushan are mining machines that produce aggregates or crushed stone. So it's possible that Wushan and other quarries were producing crushed stone with some ancient mining machinery. Today, aggregates or crushed stone are the most mined materials in the world. It's used to form concrete and asphalt. Concrete has been used as a building material for thousands of years among different cultures. It's strong, versatile, easily accessible in most areas, free from defects and flaws, unlike natural stone, and can be cast into almost any shape. These are excellent reasons for why we use concrete as the main construction material today.
Quarries like Wushan and Changyu would have produced an astronomical amount of stone. Where did the stone end up if no large stone structures are found in China? Was the stone used to extract minerals or metals?
I don't think so, because the volcanic tough stone here is really not special, since it lacks metal ores or valuable mineral deposits. Additionally, tuff is common in many areas on the planet. Was the crushed stone produced at Wushan and other massive quarries transported for global use then? I say no. Stone is widely spread all around the world. Nowadays, with developed transportation, crushed stone is still sourced locally. Large stone quarries that produce crushed stone exist near virtually every population center due to the high cost of transportation relative to the low value of the product. It's considered to be uneconomical to truck crushed stone more than 40 kilometers or 25 miles. So the large stone quarries in China would have been serving local needs. Remember the shallow continental shelf by the East China Sea? Maybe some grand stone palaces existed but now lay hidden by the rising sea and shifting sands. It's an exciting thought. In an earlier video, I discussed the possibility that the megalithic walls at Sacsayhuaman, Peru, might be cast ancient concrete. Some material analysis studies suggest that the Egyptian pyramid blocks could also be man-made. Certain Indian researchers hypothesized that the intricate stone temples in India and Sri Lanka could also be made of geopolymer. It's possible that some enigmatic structures that we have a hard time comprehending might be in fact being built with man-made stone by one or more previous civilizations. This hypothesis could better explain how such insanely heavy blocks were used to build such fantastic structures like the Great Pyramids.
If we consider the possibility that an unknown advanced civilization quarried Wushan and other massive sites with machinery, then we can speculate that these builders created their own version of concrete or geopolymer as well.
Was Wushan stone used as a base component for ancient concrete then? I think not. Commonly used concrete is lime-based, and lime comes from limestone. The 15 ancient Chinese quarries with machine marks in the same region are volcanic tuff, aluminous and siliceous stone, which cannot extract lime. I haven't found any ancient limestone quarries in China with similar machine marks. I think this is a sign that the tuff was not quarried to be a concrete component, or we would be able to find old Chinese limestone quarries as well. Then how about geopolymer? Geopolymer is an innovative material that has many advantages over the traditional Portland cement. Geopolymer are amorphous alumina silicate binder material. The tuff at Wushan is high in silica and aluminum, which means it would be an ideal material to make geopolymer. Comparing the Portland concrete, geopolymers are superior in many aspects. They are fireproof, resistant to heat and cold, have better compressive and tensile strength, and excellent properties within both acidic and salt environments. One of the important benefits of geopolymers is that they can easily cure at ambient temperatures compared to the Portland cement or concrete. Geopolymer is gaining popularity now, but yet to be widely used because it requires special handling due to chemicals such as sodium hydroxide, which can be harmful to humans. Concrete with Portland cement cures or hardens at temperatures above 5 degrees Celsius or 41 degrees Fahrenheit. Most concrete poured and placed in cold weather has a much slower setting and curing time. Fresh concrete needs to be protected from freezing for at least the first 24 hours, which makes concrete not an ideal construction material for cold regions, especially during a glacial period. As I mentioned earlier, I'm considering the possibility that Wushan Grottoes and other similar ancient quarries were excavated in prehistory times, probably during the last glacial period, when the sea level was much lower. Geopolymer would have been an ideal building material in colder times such as the last glacial period. I think a sophisticated ancient civilization not only had the ability to quarry these large-scale ancient quarries with complex machinery, but they were capable of mastering the methods to manufacture and utilize geopolymer. Thus, in some regards, this past civilization could have potentially surpassed ours with their unbelievable engineering feats. To date, not many underwater investigations have been done in the Chinese marginal sea, so we really don't know whether there are any old stone structures buried underwater. If there are indeed such treasures hidden under the sea, we might find that they are made of a sort of a geopolymer with the quarried stone from Wushan or Changyu Caves.
Okay, let's wrap it up here. Please let me know what you think of my hypothesis. I would love to hear from you. If you like my video, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe. I have a wide range of topics that I want to share with you. This is Curious Being. I'm Tina. Thanks for watching and see you next time.